This video is the second of a series of three videos where we will be talking about how you can use the Table Analyzer Wizard in complex queries to import multiple many-to-many datasets into Microsoft Access. In the previous video, I have imported data into Microsoft Access and created a single one-to-many relationship between the director table and the movie table, and a single many-to-many relationship between the movie table and the actor table, using the cast table as an association table. In this video, I'm going to use the same data to build a second many-to-many relationship. I want to bring my customer information into my database. I want to import my data again. But this time, when I bring in my data, I am not going to ignore the customer field. I will let Access choose my primary key and import my data into a table called Data Import with Customer and finish the import process. I will now create a query, clicking on the Create ribbon and clicking on Query Design. I want to pull in my Data Import with Customer table and use this table to build my list of customers. If I run the query right now, I see the information repeated many times for each row in the original Excel spreadsheet. I want to make sure that only distinct and unique values appear. I will right-click on my query window and click on Properties, making sure that I have selected the query itself, and then make sure only unique values appear by clicking on the Unique Values property. Now when I run my query, I only see 14 customers listed. In a previous video, we mentioned the SQL view. If I look at the SQL view, I can see that I am using a select to select distinct customers from the data import with customer table. The distinct keyword was added by clicking on the unique values property. Now in Design View, I will click on the Make Table query. It is asking me what the table name is that I want to make, and I will type in Customer, clicking on OK. Now, if I look at the SQL view, I can see that I am selecting the distinct customer into a customer table from Data Import with Customer. This will automatically create a table for me. I will go back to Design View and run my query. I'm about to paste 14 rows into the new table. I will click on Yes. I now have a new table in my database called Customer that contains my 14 customers. I will return to Design View on my customer table and add a primary key. I will call the new column ID, change the data type to auto number, and click on the primary key icon to ensure that it becomes a primary key. Now when I view my table in Datasheet View, I can see that there are keys assigned for each customer. This will be very important for our next step. I will close my MakeTable query that I no longer need. I will now create a new table, clicking on the Create ribbon and clicking on the table icon. I will right-click on my table name and go to Design View. I will call my table Rental. This will be my association table, creating the many-to-many relationship between movies and customers. In this table, I'm going to create a field for customer ID. I will make this a number field. I will also create a field for movie ID, making this a number field as well. I will close my table, saving the changes. Now I will click on the Create ribbon and click on Query Design. I will add my data import with customer table, and my movie table. I will use this to populate my rental table with the customer IDs and movie IDs of the movies the customers have rented. I will be creating a join. A join is a relationship between tables that is not defined by the database, but rather by the query. I will drag the customer field from my customer table to the customer field of my data import table, creating a join. Notice that it does not show any information as far as the relationship. There is no referential integrity between these two tables. This is an ad hoc relationship that only exists within this query. I will then take my title from my data import table, and I will join this with my title on my movie table, and I will rearrange these tables so that we can see this better. Now I will pull down my customer ID and pull down my movie ID. When I run this query, I see customer IDs and the movie IDs for the movies of customers who rented them. I am seeing a lot of duplicate data. I do not want to see duplicate data, so I will right-click on my query, click on Properties, and make sure that the unique values is set to Yes. I will run the query again, and this time I see that there is a total of 72 records that should be in this query. I will go back to Design View, and instead of simply running a select, I will create an Append query and append this information to my empty rental table, clicking on OK. When I append it to my rental table, I will need to specify what field it is being appended to, so I will append my ID from the customer table to the customer ID field, and append my movie ID for the movie table to the movie ID field. If I look at my SQL view, I can see the code where I am inserting into the rental table the customer ID and movies using the distinct keyword to eliminate duplicate records, and then my query and my joins. Back in Design View, I can run my query and notice that I am appending 72 rows. I will click on Yes. If I look at my rental table, I now have 72 rows in my rental table that matched my earlier query. I want to take a moment and talk about what we are doing, because this may seem a little confusing. The IDs that I am appending to my rental table did not exist in my original Excel file. The movie ID was created when I ran the Table Analyzer Wizard in the previous video. The customer ID was created when I ran my MakeTable query and added a primary key to that table just a moment ago. In order to find the customer IDs that are related to the movie IDs, I am matching the text fields for the title and the customer name and finding rows from my data import that match both fields. If these fields were not unique enough for my purposes, I could have matched on additional fields. In effect, instead of matching on foreign keys in an association table, I am matching on text fields to create the list of foreign keys that will populate my rental association table. I will save this query for use in the next video, and we will discuss how SQL can be used to delete duplicate records if we've forgotten to set the property to show only unique values. I will now click on the Database Tools ribbon and click on Relationships. I will show my rental and customer tables. I will now build my relationships. At this point, if there was any problems with the integrity of the data, it would have prevented me from building these relationships. Now that I have created these relationships, I can perform a query creating a list of what customers rented what movies. As you can see, you can actually bring in data with multiple many-to-many relationships into Microsoft Access and recreate that data with the relationships. Analyze table can be used up to a certain extent, but after that, you can use some creative queries to build your association tables.